Yes, people, it's the one and only Jew with the Love, live and direct from the Love Kitchen. Sorry, every time I record this thing with the camera this way, I feel like I'm looking over there when I should be looking there, and then when I am looking there, it looks like I'm looking over there. But anyway, people, it's the one and only Jew with the Love, live and direct from the Love Fruit, and we're not the kitchen this time. It's Sunday, my dad, my old clothes. I relaxed up myself because I wasn't feeling too well yesterday. I had to go to hospital, and oh my gosh, my mother used to say to me, God rest her soul, make sure your underwear and your vest and your panty and everything is clean before you go panty street, because you know you could drop down and everything could happen. Well, mine was well clean. I jump in the shower before I end up going there, and you know, you come out the shower, I was like, let me hurry up because I was rushing. Child mind was here, quick clean myself and all this kind of stuff. When I got there and the man went to examine my foot, my Lord of mercy, I was so ashamed, because you know what, me if you get fit cream your foot, it's not a regular thing, because I know there's a couple of you out there that don't cream your foot at all. I mean, the foot was so dry, I mean so dry, that I could write in it, hello, is it me you're looking for? NASA. That nagua. I mean to say, the foot was so dry that the white doctor's hand against my back leg looked like it was chalk against a blackboard. I couldn't believe it. I felt so shame. And then when I went for the x-ray, the man said, you can't come in here with no bra. I know you're wearing a bra. I said, how you know I'm wearing a bra? What are you trying to say? These big things are stiff. Anyway, when I took off the bar, the man then looked down and went, that's better. Nah, Bridget, why are you looking so low? Why are you looking so low? I know it's not that low yet. Anyway, people, before I can even talk anymore about that, let me talk to you about X Factor, Fiat Factor, that's what I like to call it anyway, because all of a sudden, everybody that look like me who's got a soulful voice, them can't get in back in the days, but now people that don't look like me who's got a soulful voice, them will win everything, them will get punished. Anyway, each their own, if that's what they want, but you want to come with your words about it's authentic and it's new and it's current, no it's not, we've been singing like that from day one, we've been singing like that upon Saturday or Sunday, depending on what church you go to, Seventh Adventist or Sunday, Pentecostal, we've been singing that for a long time. Anyway, this time, we want to big up the Reggie and Bowley. Oh my gosh, when you was coming on, I thought to myself, now you're going to embarrass us, because you know it's like, as a black person, when you see another black person on TV, you start getting a little nervous and start biting nails. I know some of you like to do that when you saw me on the TV, but me no business, go do your thing, Reggie and Bowley, because let me tell you something, when you came on, I thought, hold on, I was ready to azonto there and then. You lot liven up X Factor in a way that it's never been livened up before. It was like a plain boiled egg before, and you lot come like pepper and salt. You come season up the thing with your salt and pepper self. Add two chili on the X Factor. Look, the people that was going on so mad, the little piece of one button that was left on Simon's shirt did pop off. The man started to, I see him there ready. And then Cheryl with her little cucum self was jumping up and down and whining and getting excited. Cheryl, I'm coming next week with food for you, you know, because I want to see you nyam and belch. Because when you belch, at least I know you digested food and you might put on some weight, because damn your bone in your cheek. You can't be kissing up people because you might end up leaving two tribal marks in people's face. No, stop. That naga work. The people then went on so mad, they jump up and start dance up on the place. And did you hear the man after us about he didn't know he could dirty wine? He must have watched my interview. He can dirty wine and skank to One Direction at the same time. Let me show you how them lot went on. Yeah, let me show you how them lot went on at X Factor.
Tune. Nah. Watch him. Give them a run. Give them a run, Mr. Reggie and Bolly. Watch ya. Make your body. Do your thing. We know say immigration look for you, but them sex straight, them nice, them have everything them want. We see wife, no worry yourself. Nah, so big them up. I have to. I love the other pieces. I dance until I sweat. Big up yourself, Reggie and Bolly. We have your back. One love is one like Jordan Love. That can work. How you mean?